All right, my brother Noomsi, season me. 3. Back at it again. Brother Noomsi has forgiven me. Co-host brother Deron Dixon. Got a special guest again, brother Kevin Redby. So good. On the last episode, we had to bring him back.
Absolutely.
So I hope all is well with you, brothers.
Yeah, everything's good my way.
Yeah, for sure. Everything's real good. Can't complain.
Good.
What about yourself?
Everything's lovely, man. Everything is lovely.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Got my first shot, first vaccine. Yeah, I took the Pfizer. Just a little arm soreness, just like a regular shot, but no concerns. Got my next one coming up next week. So if people out there are skeptical, you know, it affects different people different ways, but when you get vaccinated, the more the merrier.
Agree. I'm right with you. I got both of mine. My advice, go do some push-ups, go work out, do something active with that arm, because it will be sore. I know my wife, she got her second dose and it really took her down, like chills, flu-like symptoms, but after she woke up the next day, ate some breakfast, worked out a little bit, she was good the next day. But yeah, I'm right with you. Go ahead and get vaccinated. Please, let's get back to some type of normalcy for sure.
Yeah, I got none. I'm holding out because I'm going to have to eventually. So I'm just going to wait until that day when they tell me I got to.
But you, at least you for it. You know what I mean? So
yeah, I am for it, also for more long-term information too.
Agree.
All of this stuff has came out real quick.
Mm-hmm.
None of this stuff is supposed to be real quick, but hey, hopefully they did effects long-term.
Right.
Talking about, have you suffered from
CTC, cut the check, homie, because I do suffer from all of the above.
Right. That's one. In a way, if something happens, that it's going to be a big payout for everybody because it's too many people who got it. You know what I mean? Like, it's going to be like $100 maybe.
Yeah, I mean, but at the same time, on the flip coin, right, just playing that other side of the coin, with this being out so fast and everybody pushing it, there shouldn't be no more excuses with future vaccines, future cures. You know what I mean? Cut the political nonsense that goes behind medicine, right? If this was to go successful, no side effects, et cetera, that just leads to show like, all right, future vaccines, future cures. This should be the same process, you know? Yeah. If it's mandatory, make it mandatory. If it's, if it can push through fast, push it. So,
and that just cost. Like, what was that they was pushing at one time? Where was it the AIDS cure? Or not cure, but I guess a treatment, a form of treatment for AIDS or HIV? And old boy was jacking up the prices. Same dude that bought that Wu-Tang album. You know what I'm talking about? Like, come on, man. Like, when people are hurting and in need, like, just get them what they need, man. Like,
agree.
It's not that big of a deal. Like, how many millions can you make? You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, how much stuff can you have before you like, all right, I got enough. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm comfortable, and I don't even break 100K a year, you know what I'm saying? So I don't understand why people, get so greedy and all that, you know what I mean? When people are hurting, like don't use people hurting to try to make money off of them. Cause they could have sold this mug and been like, nah, $1,000 a pop, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean,
talking about getting back to some normalcy, man. You tell that to everybody else, they feel like it's already normal. I saw them pictures from spring break in Miami, man.
See, that's delusional, right? Them people lost their minds, man.
Man, not just that, but the All-Star game too, right? Like,
yeah, All-Star weekend.
Everybody was in Atlanta, like, Like, it wasn't nothing. And the crazy part about it was nobody was at the game because the game was monitored. So it's like, all y'all went down to All-Star Weekend for what? For parties?
To catch the Rona. That's what they did. All-Star Weekend jacked up a lot of relationships, too, though. I don't know if y'all saw.
It really wasn't even that serious. I mean, it wasn't
I don't even know what happened, bro. Like, I've been seeing the fallout, but I'm like, dog.
And after a while, I was like, my guilty, going back to guilty pleasure, World Star, like, it was just video after video after video. I'm like, damn, what happened? People taking L's, cars getting jacked. All-Star Weekend. I don't know if it was a come up or what down there.
Some people came up, people who was taking them rims and those
things. Yeah. Oh, man, that's crazy. Speaking of basketball, what y'all brackets looking like right now? Mine's trash.
I didn't do it.
You ain't do it?
Mine's
trash. Trash.
No, I didn't do it because, I didn't do it last year. Well, obviously nobody did last year, but looking at college ball this year, you know, being fortunate to play and, you know, being a student of the game, it was weak for me. It was like one or two, I would say about three or four teams that I'll actually sit down and watch. But a lot of those games were terrible.
I didn't watch none. I watched zero.
And I knew, like, a lot of the big heads were going to get knocked off top. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, nah, I just did my little bracket and just guessed, and I guessed wrong. Like,
who did you have that you were just like, gee?
Who did you have as the champion?
Michigan.
Me too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And that's one of the teams that I actually watched this year because they play defense. Michigan, Florida State. Illinois was cool to watch, but yeah, they.
Oh, I had Purdue going a little deeper. Like, they took that L. I expected more out of them. Who else? I'm pulling my bracket right now, man. Like, it's trash.
What you say about Gonzaga, Lamar?
Nah, they was doing. They pretty good too.
Yeah.
I got Gonzaga going pretty far too. Come on now. Who took L for me, man? So many. Yeah. Let's see here, Virginia.
Yeah.
Georgetown.
That hurt my heart, man.
Anytime. I mean, it's some teams are staples. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They lose, you like, come on, man. You're supposed to at least make it to Sweet 16.
But, for Patrick to turn around the program where it was, mm-hmm. I just knew it was destiny. You know, the Jordan 3s came out, Georgetown edition, and I was just like, oh, yeah. They're going all the way. I'm glad I'm not a betting man because I would have put money on it. It was just, you know, the stars were lining up and then L.
Yeah, Purdue lost to North Texas. Like, where they balling at in North Texas? It's not even, like, it's just North Texas. It's not even a place. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a directional region. Like, what the thing? Bruh. Oral Roberts smashed.
I couldn't even point that out on the map.
Bro.
Nah, especially, it's another one I was just like, who? Alba, I can't even say their names.
Where they go? Where, Oral Roberts. That was crazy.
Let me see. I had Missouri beating Oklahoma. I'm going to show you which one I had. That was a terrible one.
Abernathy Christian something, man, that's going to bother me.
Loyola, Chicago.
But they've done it before. That's not.
Like,
yeah.
I mean, you're not supposed to. Like, what are you doing?
I mean, I think the nun, she giving up some Jesus milk to them boys, breastfeeding them or something, man. Like, she like 150 still at the games, cheering them on. She's
that's one that got me. Oral Roberts in Ohio State too. That was like, man, for real, Ohio?
The Ohio. Hey, yeah. So speaking of that, I was in a I was on a film shoot yesterday, right? Doing camera work.
And, okay, big dog.
Yeah, that's what I do. one of the actors, he was from Detroit originally, but he live in Atlanta now. And so he was like, man, what y'all bracket look like? Blah, blah, blah. I was like, oh, yeah, I got Michigan. And he was like, nah. He was like, man, my bracket already messed up because I had Ohio State. I said, wait, what? You from Detroit and Michigan, right. Ohio State? I was like, that's blasphemy, bro. I don't care how long you've been gone. Like, you can't do that. Like, what's wrong with you? I don't even care if you didn't pick Michigan, but you do not pick Ohio State, or you can't pick Notre Dame, which Notre Dame is trash in basketball anyway. But, like, you just can't do those things. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, my God.
So if he was, it don't matter if he was just born there and raised somewhere else, he still
care. I don't care. You could have been born in Michigan, raised in Ohio. You better not pick Ohio State.
That ain't right, man. That ain't. That sound like Hilton, though. Hilton, he ain't even from that area, but he runs all the way Wolverine. Yeah. All the way Wolverine.
I hate Ohio State with a passion. I ain't never been. It's probably a lovely campus. Probably nice people, great teachers, great staple of education. However, they sports teams are trash just off the simple fact that I'm a Michigan fan.
I mean, they just swagged out there, though.
What?
That the red and silver, they swagged out.
That's
out there.
Terrible, so man. Them lazy colors. Get out of here with that. Lazy. Them all-white uniforms with some red and some, like, a silver lining. Get out of here. Swag. Ain't nothing swag about that.
I ain't gonna start. They be all right. But I want to talk about swag.
Oregon is swag. Like, Oregon colors is crazy. They uniforms always.
Their uniforms. Yeah.
They court be crazy. Like, everything they do is just, man.
When you got the Nike person pumping dollars into your program, you're going to be all right.
For sure.
I saw, you know, how some YouTubers do that unveiling video of certain things. It was an Oregon track athlete. And I'm talking about shoes, gear, everything just kept on. I'm like, yo, you don't even have to buy a wardrobe. I'll just wear that the entire time. Nike. I'm like, man, good to be an Oregon Duck.
That's crazy. Yeah. I messed up. I should have went to Oregon. I should have been in bowling or something. Just to get there. You know what I mean?
You would have got, yeah. And could have made some money, all that. He's not going to wear all of that. You're going to sell it. Well, he'll probably give it away. He was a white boy.
But I mean, you got to wait till you graduate anyway before you start selling gear that was given to you. You know what I mean? Otherwise, you might lose that scholarship.
Yeah. I'm going to wait for that. No.
Yeah, nah. I mean,
I'm hitting the barbershop right after I get it.
I got robbed, coach. There's something wrong. It's like, give me all your stuff. I was like, I ain't got nothing. It was like, what about all that Nike gear in the corner? I was like,
you can have it.
Take that.
You can have it. Nah, man, but I didn't get robbed. Like me being in the room, but our apartment, I don't know if I ever shared this with you. When I was at Ball State, we had an apartment in Hendersonville. It was around Christmas time. Never forget this because I got some Timberlands for Christmas, and I wore it the night before our road game, and I put it in my room. We had a road game, gone for the weekend, come back, door busted down. Nobody else's stuff is gone but mine and the person I was sharing the room with. The other two people, they play ball too, but miraculously all their stuff is still in the room.
When you with somebody from Antioch?
Who's your Ty from McGavick.
From McGavick.
Right? Yeah. Dre from Hunters. Because he went to McGavin.
He set you up.
What are you trying to, what are you trying to say about McGavin? You
know, nah, it ain't about McGavin. It's about Ty.
No,
I'm clowning. I'm clowning.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
He was all right, dude.
Nah, he was. He was. He was straight. He was crazy, but he was straight, though. But yeah, it pissed me off, man. But you can't say nothing because, I mean, I could be like, yo, what happened? But they was on the trip with me, but all my, not all, but my gear, those Timberlands was stolen and two outfits that matched them. Super hot. But it's all good. That was my only time ever experiencing something even close to being robbed.
Yeah. Nah, it never happened to me. So, what's on the agenda today? Got off on these brackets and everything.
Yeah. I mean, for me, I mean, what's up with that snowfall?
Oh, I'm caught up.
I haven't been caught up, but it's dope, though.
I'm caught up.
It's good.
I think I'm on season three. I'm not season three. I'm sorry. Episode three of season four.
So the last episode, the last season, right?
The new season that's out.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's what I'm saying. Okay. Yeah. What you mean in Duran, you caught up? You just had to start all up? Where'd you?
Nah, you know, last time we talked, I don't even think I was.
You wasn't on it like that.
Nah. So now okay. I'm 100. I'm like, I'm live. So now, like, now whenever the new episode drop, that's my next ready. Episode to watch.
Yeah, that's what's up.
I'm in that life, man. Like, I'm out here, I'm selling it, I'm cooking it, you know, busting in people's houses.
It makes you want to go there.
Hey, I'm ready to kill everybody. Like, I'm like, man, y'all crazy for letting that person live. I'd have shot her. When you in the life, you got to be in it. You know what I'm saying? You got to be good.
Yeah. Yeah, some of them are, though. But frankly, he ain't about that.
Nah, he ain't about that,
nah,
man.
Nah, he about getting that money. I ain't mad at him.
You know who grew on me? Because I ain't like him at first, but Reed, the CIA agent. Reed, white boy. Nah, man. When they went up in
I don't like him at all.
When they went up in that Mexican sheriff house and smashed all them cats, I was like, all right, Reed, I see you.
Nah, the Mexican dude is the one.
Oh yeah,
which one? Also.
Hey, he about that life.
He about anything you want.
Yeah.
You want bare hands? You want a knife? You want what? You want me to make something up real quick so we can fight with it?
The funny part is he wants you to watch, though. He'd be like, I'll kill him, but you're going to be there. Because that's going to be on you. They blood going to be on you. You ain't just going to be coming out clean.
Yeah, Snowfall's good. Snowfall's real. It's put together well because you can see the growth of each character. Like, even with this season, hopefully no spoiler, but just the relationship with Franklin and his homie. The one that got the project.
Lee.
Yeah. Like, at first, click tight, but you know what I mean? Just with the whole business of everything.
Yeah.
Sometimes things change, but yeah. But yeah, I think they did a real job. I just want to see it keep on going, even though it gets probably stupid after a while.
I think this is the final season, ain't it? This might be it. It's either this one or the next one. It ain't got much. Ain't much left.
Nah, man. Just the title. Because dope doesn't stop. I mean, dope kept on going.
Yeah.
Even though this is originating in the 80s of how it became prevalent in the hood, still there.
Yeah.
So the title could definitely keep on going. I could see that going. Just hell, Fast and the Furious kept on going. That should have been done.
Should have. Yeah.
So I see, like, even on that type of level, I want to see this to keep going. It's real good. Me and the missus have to get caught up. I think the last episode we saw, matter of fact, it might have been the first two that premiered that night.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think those were the last two we saw. We gotta get caught up though.
Nah, yeah, I'm all the way caught up. I'm ready.
Yeah.
And I like old boy from the Wood. He played Scully. He was Stacy in the Wood, and then he was also in Dope with
At
Rocky and all them.
The crazy.
Yeah, he played the same. He played Stacy in Dope, so he had. Yeah.
He got the dude that be fit. Dropping.
Yeah, he'd be on that drip.
Dude is crazy, man.
He crazy, but he killing that role. Like he killing it because he legit seem crazy.
Like all the way.
Yeah.
Like I'm not acting right now. I'm just being myself.
Nah, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's good. But speaking of just things that make you please tell me y'all listened to Benny the Butcher, man.
I did listen to the new, you talking about the new one?
The new one.
I listened to it.
Wait,
as I saw it, I was like, I need to download this.
Absolutely.
The plugs I meet too.
Yes. Yeah. It's meeting Hope, Mies and Sosa is good. It's another song that's on there that start with the I. Lauren has my phone right now. But going to your point, Deron, of how things make you want to do, like listen to Benny, I feel like I want to be on the block right now, like pushing that hard for real. That's all he's talking about. Going to that guilty press pleasure, just every time hitting you with bars, and you just like, man, I need to find a car that has a hidden compartment, and I need to start selling that weight.
Yeah, nah, I fool with it. I like the longevity with French Montana.
Longevity, that's Jones. It. That yeah. is the song. It's yeah. sorry, I said an I, but it's longevity. Yeah. That right there, everybody should listen to that. You can take it and apply it to any part of life. So yes, agree.
I'm for it. I miss my calling, man. I could have been out here in these streets. I see the game. I see it better than anybody else. Like I ain't going to jail.
Nah, man, I would have been. Fuck. Excuse me, Lauren. F that. I would have been. Yeah, I would have been a bad dope person.
Nah, I couldn't sell. I would have to be like Franklin in distribution.
I couldn't
be out on no corner.
Nah, because I'm too paranoid. Like, you reaching and giving me money, I'm accidentally shooting you in kneecap. Like, I don't know what's going on. Yeah. So, yeah, I couldn't have.
I would either have to be an enforcer or a distribution. That's the only way I can go. Like, there's no standing on the corner. Oh, I ain't got no heart.
I couldn't be an enforcer because if I get locked up or if I get gemmed up, I'm like, yeah, that nigga right.
Yeah, are you
right down that way?
Oh, speaking of which,
easy.
What's the dude name? 6ix9ine. So I was at Zany's Friday, right? And we
right.
For Lil Duval. He was at Zany's. So we was there early, you know, sitting there waiting for him to come out or whatever. They started playing some 6ix9ine. I immediately looked at Reels like, man, don't they know black folks don't fool with 6ix9ine snitching stuff? So the song got about 30 seconds in, then they cut it. And then the dude next to me, black dude, was like, man, we don't listen to that. Like, it's so funny. I'm like, somebody must have ran up on him and told him, man, you don't cut that garbage off, man.
Yeah. But what makes it worse with him is like, you was flogging this whole time like you was about that. You know what I'm saying? Like, you repping it, you doing this, you glorifying it, you even telling your homies to go do X, Y, and Z.
Mm-hmm.
But that's something like it really hit the fan for dude, and dude saw it and was like, nah, he made a business decision.
He's still talking tough though. Like, how you still talking tough?
Because like, people still paying him.
You a pop star, all right? You a pop star. Like, come on, man. You an actor.
After watching Snowfall, he may be an informant now.
Yeah.
Like, been an informant.
But nah, I mean, money, man. People are still paying, dude. Once, like, look at Trey, what's his name? The dude that shot Megan Thee Stallion, what's his?
Tory
Lanez.
Tory Lanez.
Right. So, dude's really declining. His last album ain't really selling. Like, people ain't pumping money into dude. Like, for some reason, somewhere, somehow, people are still pumping money into that other cat.
Into 6ix9ine. I guess it's all who backing you. You know what I mean?
He should not be named.
Yeah, I wasn't going to say it, but I appreciate you saying the name.
I thought that.
Yeah. You know, subtle things. Subtle things, Mr. Dixon. Subtle things.
But yeah, man. Snowfalls. It got me out here, man. I'm
all right, man. Nah, say it a couple times. Man.
Right.
Not in the drug game.
Who the plug?
I'm just going to start kicking.
You got a lot of area out there in your way. You know what I'm saying? You got Hermitage, you got Hendersonville.
Oh, we got the lake, buddy. You know what I mean? We're going to be like Ozark. We're going to be on the water.
Hey, man, I can't wait for that to come back. That's another good show.
Hold on, man. This man's referencing too many. I'm on this. What's your address again? All right.
Look, informant. Hold on. Let me stop. I'm feds at my door. Kevin, drop a dime. Look, I saw you hit record. That's what you just did. You just hit record.
Dimes. How much? Okay, 50K. All right. Got you.
Look, can you say that again, please?
Yeah.
One more time.
Right. But these young cats, they so dumb, they just putting their information out on themselves. Like,
dude,
detectives, they got.
And they got location on. Like, they don't even take the geotag off. Yeah, we out here, we got guns and stuff. Yeah, look at all this. We got ounces. Where am I though?
They make it so easy to get caught up trying to flodge on the internet.
Man, if you don't get off your phone.
Man, you
mentioned the Ozark, though, but I'm ready for that one to come out, kind of, too.
Yeah,
I missed that.
That is legit the last season, too, the Ozark.
I've never got into that.
Really? Oh, it's slow. It's
Chelsea got it. It's good. Let me make sure I'm on the same wavelength. Is it with the two? It's a family, white family, that gets put out in the middle. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Out in
Chelsea got in. Yeah, Chelsea got into it. And they doing their own thing, money laundering and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I think I caught like a few episodes into it with the missus. Mm. That's her ish. Like, she's all about Ozark. So all where's right. it coming out?
It's so he's an accountant. Like the main guy.
No, I'm saying when's the next season?
I don't know. Oh, I think it should be this year though.
Okay.
Should be later this year, probably the fall.
Yeah, I'm looking at it right now, trying to find out when it comes out. It's the end of 2021.
Yeah. End of 2021. She'll be happy to hear that. She got all the way into that one.
Yeah, the storyline to bring you in, man. What I don't like is the kids.
Snitching. The kids. They be wilding, man. They gotta go.
You wrapped up to the storyline, I don't care. I mean, you could be kids gotta go.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, you gotta be, if you in the game, you gotta be about that life. You gotta kill everybody. Anybody that's gonna jeopardize your business has got to go.
Didn't they get into something though? Like, didn't the boy have something going on to his sister?
He shot a dude.
Oh, see.
Did he freeze up?
He froze.
Pointed
the gun.
Yeah.
But the girl is the one who's snitching on everybody.
Oh, man.
For real.
She got a mouth.
We ain't trying to spoil it for you.
I'm not going to watch. Like, certain shows, I'll check it out. Not going to lie, but I ain't going to be putting into it, like last week, not trying to change real quick, but we talked about that WandaVision. I know that's on the agenda, but I'll try it out. This just is an example. Like, I'll try it out. If it catch my attention, oh yeah, I'm all the way in. Now, if I try it out and I miss something and somebody be like, yo, go check it out again, then I give it another shot. But me on my own, nah, you only get one shot with me to catch me, and then it's a wrap unless somebody else say something.
I think the one show that really caught me, like, within the first 30 seconds, like that Letterkenny to Duran told me about.
The what?
Letterkenny.
You hear me?
Letterkenny.
The Letterkenny, yeah. Yeah.
What's that
TV
on?
TV show that's based.
Hulu.
Hulu.
Okay.
But like the very first scene, dude, cracked me up. I was like in tears.
All right, I'll check it out. Something to happen. So I could check it out.
Yeah. You might as well talk about the
but my you show.
Talk about that WandaVision. You brought it up.
Right.
Yeah, I can talk about it. But to Lamar's point, Game of Thrones was like that for me. That first couple of seconds of the show, I was hooked all the way in, all the way in. And then it got like that whole incest going on. I was like, all right, that's too much, but I'm still locked in. But to WandaVision, man, you were right. I ain't gonna lie. Double D, Lamar, y'all both were right. Y'all said check it out. I wasn't dramatic and went to the fourth one, but I did get, I couldn't give episode one another shot. I'm sorry. But I did start again on episode two, and then I thugged it out, and then it started to make sense of where they were and how it came about.
Did you get all to the end?
I just finished where Vision, her, I think it's the end. Vision and her fought the witch in Vision and the other Vision.
Yeah. You finished it.
Okay. And then, but what I don't, the question I had was, what happened to the other Vision after his eyes was open?
He just left.
TBD.
Yeah, he just bounced.
That's what I'm saying. Like, yeah. Okay, cool. So that lets me know that would come back around.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was good. I was hooked. And what made me even hook was we scheduled the show, and I was like, oh, man, I ain't going to be the dude not to watch something after I said I'm going to watch it. So I binged it real quick before we hopped on. But yeah, it was good. It was real good.
I thought it was good, too. I mean, for what it was, I think it was like a mini movie, really.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see what she's gonna do in the future.
Yeah,
I mean, she got all this power now. Yeah. What is Doctor Strange? That's gonna be the movie now.
Yeah.
And the thing about that too, I'm liking how Marvel at first when once again going to that first episode, I was like, "What the F, Marvel? Like, you have a great opportunity to do what the comic books did. You know, you had this big comic like." Throwing out the X-Men out there. And then you had these side people on one or two, what am I trying to say? Not episodes, but in the comic world. Not episodes. But anyway, you introduce certain people and then you have the spinoffs.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like with the TV shows, they're doing that with the comic books, you know? Have the big Avenger movies and everybody's individual movie, but now there's a little spinoff with characters that you fell in love with, you know, so that's good. And how they introduced the Scarlet Witch, I thought that was cool too.
Yeah. I mean, like, because when you look back on it, you really didn't get a whole lot about her to begin with. So it was good.
Not at all.
Like flesh out her story, see her past, see that even before Age of Ultron, she was already, like, she already had power. She had powers as a kid, is pretty much what you were trying to say. So, you know, you got to dive into that at some point. You're going to have to answer that question, like, what gave her powers as a kid, her and her brother? Because I'm assuming if she had powers, then he did. So it'll be real interesting to see where they take it. And then with Agnes or Agatha, once Scarlet Witch, spoiler, absorbed her power, she said, "You don't know what you've just done." So what does that mean? What's the implications of her taking Agnes' powers? You know what I mean? Like, was Agnes fending off some stuff that we just don't know about that's going to come out later? Like, she was keeping the mutant gene down? Who knows? You know what I'm saying? We don't know what was happening. So it'll be real interesting to see where they go from here.
Man, I would love for them to come around and say that Quicksilver and Scarlet Witch is actually Magneto's kids.
Her outfit was very Magneto.
Yeah. Like all the way Magneto.
That Indian outfit, it was so Magneto.
Yeah, all the way.
But still, you know, nobody's said anything. Like, they're still keeping them separate.
Well, he ain't there yet. You know, the mutants as a whole really ain't in the universe yet. It's coming.
They could have spent the story and say that those two were adopted by that family who got killed. And that would have left the door open to say, you know, he's around somewhere.
Right, yeah. Nah, I get that. They got a lot more story to tell. It'll be real interesting. And one thing that I have to keep in mind is that WandaVision originally wasn't supposed to come out yet, or it didn't come out in the order that it was supposed to come. You know what I mean? Like, we're supposed to get Black Widow, then Falcon Winter Soldier, then WandaVision. And we got WandaVision before we got the other two. So I don't know if they took stuff out that would end up being potential spoilers for the others. So that'll be interesting to see if something down the line, once the other two come out, which Falcon's already, you know, Falcon Winter Soldier's already started. if they come out and say, like, oh yeah, by the way, like, let's backtrack into WandaVision, this was a part of that.
Did you watch the first episode of Falcon and Winter Soldier?
Yeah.
I haven't yet. I almost did, but something came up. I just haven't got to it yet. Was it good?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah, good.
I liked it. It feels more like an Avengers.
yeah. That's, you know, give me the blow up. Give me some action.
Yeah. Nah, you get that. It's a nice little like aerial chase scene.
Yeah.
So it's definitely, it feels like the Avengers or like a Civil War, not Civil War, like a Winter Soldier.
Yeah. But, also, giving props to the creators of WandaVision was why it was transforming from the 50s to the 60s. Like, why was it a sitcom? What was the whole purpose of that? So you got that towards the end. So that was cool. The tie-ins was dope. The beginning, I'm like, yeah, you need to put a disclaimer at the very beginning.
That's why I tell people go to see episode 4 when you start to see behind the curtain, because then it starts to bring everything together and you're like, oh, okay, that's what they're doing.
Yeah, that's stupid. But anyways, it worked.
But this week, and I know, Kevin, I already talked to you about it. You said you ain't seen it, but this week belonged to Justice League, Zack Snyder's Justice League. Which you in the letterbox in his aspect ratio, because that's how the movies play. Instead of being widescreen, it's in a box like you are. yeah, man, like, I don't know what's wrong with Warner Brothers to where they saw what Zach was doing and then they was like, all right, nah, you know, your daughter passed, why don't you step away? And then they called Josh Whedon in to punch it up. And then they was like, you know what? I really like what Josh Whedon did. We're going to put this version of the movie out and not that. Like, idiots. Complete idiots. And I know we're 4 years later, essentially, because it was supposed to, the original came out in 17.
It's been that long.
Yeah. But still, like.
And that's where you get to the point, like, what if his version would have been out? Because I know when I saw the original 2017, I was like, y'all rushed this and y'all cut a lot of shit out, and this should have been as dope as Marvel. That's what I said on the first go around. Yeah. So when it pops up on now on TMT, the only scenes I love watching was watching Flash old-ish moment when Superman noticed when he noticed Superman can see.
Yeah. I love that. I love that.
That's a Zack Snyder scene. Like Zack shot that.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. They even cut it. It's different. It's the same thing, but it's slightly different.
Like, okay.
Superman's like trying to get at Flash more, and he's like dodging him a little bit more in the actual Zack Snyder version.
Yeah.
Like it's a little bit different, but it's the same thing where he's still like, he's like, how can he see me?
I thought that was funny. So those type of scenes. So that even if I name another scene, it might be Zach. So I didn't think the whole thing was done well, but were some scenes.
Josh's movie was the whole. Zach's is more about drama, character development, which I like. But
me too.
A whole bunch of the comedy that was from the first one that I like some of the comedy. I like some of the flashes, quick comebacks and stuff like that. But it wasn't a whole bunch of that in this movie, in the Zack Snyder one, which was okay, but I enjoyed those little small tidbits that was in Josh's.
But some of it was forced in Josh. I mean, like some of it landed, but some of it was forced. I think this has comedy. You just have to, they're just in subtle moments and there's not like a punchline joke. You know what I mean? It's like, say for instance, I'm spoiling a little bit, but when, Flash is like, so in Justice, they digging up the grave, right? Him and Cyborg. In this version, while they're doing that, Flash is like, you think Wonder Woman will date a younger man? And Cyborg's like, dude, she's over 500 years. Everybody's a younger man. Like, that's a little, like, it's a nice little joke that's not like smacking you in the face. And then they just move on. Like, they just keep it going.
Mm-hmm. I'll check it out. I ain't gonna lie, I'm not gonna commit a full 4 hours.
Say that it doesn't seem like 4 hours.
Nah, it don't. It flows.
3 hours nice. Real quick, and I was like, man, I just wanted to keep watching it, but after 3 hours, I was like, man, I need to go to bed. But it don't seem like it's that long. It really don't.
Nah, I watched it all. I was like, I'm just gonna be hurting at work tomorrow. Cause it's from the jump. As soon as you see it come on in the action, like the first action scene is probably the Wonder Woman scene. And it just plays so differently. It's the same scene. It's just played a whole lot different.
It is.
When she stops the bank robbers or whatever.
Yeah.
As soon as she busts through the door, boom. Completely different music. Like you just get a different feel. You're like, oh, this is epic. And then she just starts smashing cats like in a warrior type way. You know what I mean? Okay, this is what this is going to be. All right. And then everybody has a purpose. It's no, like, in the 17 version, like, I just feel like a lot of people didn't have nothing to do. You know what I mean? Like, Cyborg didn't really have nothing to do. Even Flash, he ain't had nothing to do. Aquaman seemed like an idiot. In this version, everybody has something to do, and all of them are intelligent, and they're all looked at as gods. You know what I mean? Like, they make a point when you first see Aquaman to show you like, oh, people worship him. You know what I mean? Like he's a god. Batman is huge among, like he's huge. So every time you see him walking with them, like he's all buffed up and stuff. It's like, oh, okay. I see why he fits with them. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, he's just some regular dude.
Well, good. Cause I know when I saw the first one, I was like, yeah, they rushed this. This was terrible.
Yeah.
And how it went. And granted, you are comparing it to how excellent Marvel debuted each story. It did not flow. Like I even asked, like, okay, how would you continue on with Cyborg with this? You know, I said that. How would you continue on with Flash right now with this? You know, Aquaman already had his movie, whatnot, but even if that was his debut, you couldn't continue on with that. So it was bad to me. Action was real good, but the movie wasn't all.
Yeah, wait till you see this action. It's completely different. The ending is completely different.
Good.
I even finished everything differently. When Superman come on scene, it's different. It's a good feeling. Like, oh, yeah, there goes Soup.
Yeah, they about to win now.
Yeah, nah, it's hands down. Like, oh, yep, fight's over. Fight's over.
No question.
Kenny Smith on dunk contest. Let's go home, ladies and gentlemen. It was over.
Yeah, no questions.
That was epic. That was off of the Vince Carter joke when he said that. That was epic. That whole dunk contest was. All right, I know that's off topic. So that you threw in Kenny Smith, I'm just thinking T-Mac, Vince, everybody in that joint. But yeah, damn, Steve Francis was in that thing.
Franchise.
But back to the movie. All right, I'll check it out. I'll check it out one weekend.
Hopefully we can get more. I hope they wise up and decide to go with this route, because as of today, which is Monday, they're still saying, nope, we're not doing no more with this. Like, that was it. But I don't see, like, it's a moneymaker. I don't see why you would turn down money. Like, if you put out a part two, everybody's going to go see it now. Because it's an event now. You know what I mean? Like, it's a cultural event. Because there's so much hype around it. So, like, let's just keep this going.
What is it called whenever people watch it a whole bunch of times and you're trying to gauge how many people watched it?
Like, you talking about, like, the analytics of it?
Yeah, but what is it called? It was something else, like, it's another word, not analytics, but it's something else. I was trying to probably Google it and see, like.
I don't know.
How many times it was watched.
Clicks and stuff?
Yeah.
They ain't gonna give you that. All they gonna do is say it was our most watched show or most watched movie. You know what I mean? Like, that's the thing about this streaming stuff is they don't give no numbers, no concrete numbers unless it greatly benefits them to say so. But really, they're not gonna do it for Justice League because that would force them to do a part two. You came back and said this was the most watched movie that we've ever put out on HBO. Then you have to now explain to the people why you're not giving a part two.
So it came out on HBO?
Yeah, on HBO Max.
Yeah, I don't have any. I use Soap today.
Yeah,
that's my ish right there. That's how I catch it. But I don't know.
I'm pretty sure it did well. I mean, everybody's been saying it because that's what everybody's been waiting on. It's
like
a Marvel movie, like you said.
Yeah.
This is the most anticipated movie that's coming out this year.
Yeah, the only negative thing that I've heard was the 4-hour thing. That's like, I think I was sharing that with Double D. In terms of mixed reviews, it was long, but if it's action packed, I'm
fans.
Good.
They're not fans. If you hear somebody saying that it was long, they're not a fan.
They could have cut out some slow mo. They could have left some of it in regular speed just to kind of kill some of that time. But that's about it. That's the only thing I can see you taking out, because everything else was done well. Just chop it up. It's in seven parts, seven or eight parts anyway. Yeah. So, like, you got little bookmarks that you can go to. So, if you don't
want
to digest it all at once, just hit pause. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
come back to it. Stop at 2 hours and then come back 2 hours, the next
time. But like Lamar said, if it just depends on what I have going. If I don't have anything going, I could find myself just sitting there. Pause, go get some popcorn, do something, turn my theater all the way up. Theater. My man cave. Mute my sound all the way up.
Yeah. I mean, we stream anyway, you know what I'm saying? I hardly ever watch just one episode or something. So it's about the same thing.
Yeah, but I will have a theater soon, man. I got an 84-inch pull down with a projector screen that I need to put up.
Mm.
Only thing I'm waiting on is some new furniture. So I'll invite y'all over.
Okay.
What's up?
Balling, you know what I'm saying?
Nah, it was 150. I already had the sound system.
Hey, I'm not counting your pockets.
Huh?
I'm not counting your pockets.
But let's put that disclaimer out there before anybody try to hit me over for some money. Don't have it. Y'all the ballers. Look at the watch. I see.
this is a Casio.
Don't tell Casio. Whatever, man. But yeah, man.
What I
put on there?
Yeah, what you got?
What's that?
Yeah, what you?
I think we good guys and marriage. I think that was pretty much it. I know it was my baby got the phone, but just wanted to touch on good guys, man. I feel like we're the iron breed, like real talk. Because being in the school system, you see the good guys try so hard to be themselves, but being themselves ain't getting them nowhere with the girls or any type of popularity, right? And it's a good, genuine dude, right? And then you see this punk little dude come over here with the drip. And be so disrespectful. Like one time, no lie, can't make this up. And I checked the shorty on this too. It was 2 years ago. This was pre-COVID. 2 years ago, there was this girl. I was on lunch duty. Not gonna say any names. I could tell this scenario, right? She at the table talking to her friends. This little dude, I guess she was liking on, pulled a major stunt move. Went to her, was like, man, get your ass up. Just like that. And she looked at him, and he was like, yeah, you heard me, get up. And she got up. Daddy Mo went into straight effect. I was like, girl, if you don't sit down and don't let him talk to you like that. And here he go, man, I was just playing Mr. Agba. Nah, man, we don't do that. And I'm just saying, like, those type of dudes... Mm-hmm. That's what the girls like. And then the good guys are turning into those type of guys now. And it's sad. Just to get the chicks, man. They can't even, it's sad to see because, and I'm thankful to be in a position to put some dudes on game, but some dudes don't even want to listen. You know what I mean? But it's like, you can't even be yourself with this generation anymore.
I don't think it's a generational thing. I think it's always been like that.
It's always been like that.
I remember being in school and having similar experiences, being a good guy, getting passed up on for some dude. You know, you like, man, come on, man. Like, this cat, you know,
right,
like,
he right,
got three
right.
babies already. Like, we juniors. like, why are you going to be with this cat?
It's you know so I mean? Truthful.
And then when you go through college, it's the same thing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like now, the only difference is in college, you see a difference between your freshman year and them girls to your senior year. Because by the senior year, they start to realize like, oh, wait, hold on.
This
cat. I need to be somebody that actually got a degree or that's going to do something with their life. So then they come around. And by that point, you're like, nah, I'm not dating nobody at this school. Like... Because you already know everybody's business. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Come on, man.
But yeah, you are right. It always been like that.
My homeboy just hit that. Nah, I'm not. Nah, don't talk to me now.
But the disrespect, folk, like if you could see it in real time, you'd be like, oh, yeah, y'all little dudes is wild.
I was reading something or watching something on YouTube. I can't remember what it was, but it was like, man, that's how super villains get made.
Yes.
I saw something on it.
Yes. Yes.
It was like some girl curving this dude. And it was like, this is how some villains made.
Yes. That's making cool, a big deal true. With the proposal, you get shot down and stuff like that. Yes.
But that's so true. Because if you get embarrassed like that, or you get played to the left so many times, then all of a sudden you stop giving it, you know, you stop caring. So then you start using your goodwill for bad.
Yeah, no, that is true. I liked how you had your own bleep there when you said it too. That was cool. No, but I agree. Like, but I feel like that's later. Like, I got the prime age. I got 14 to 16. That's my age group right now with the freshmen. And I'm just like, ain't no way you coming into my house, man. Ain't no way my daughter's bringing somebody like you. And then I looking at the good dudes, I'm like, bro, just go watch your faves, man. Just, you know, go talk to her. Go say something. Nah, Mr. Abby. I'm like, oh my gosh, what's going on? So yeah, they turn into supervillains.
That's a tough age, man. That's a tough time. You know what I mean? Like, yo.
Hello?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Oh. Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, yeah.
Nah, I was just saying that, like, that's a tough time, you know what I mean? Like, because you got so much going on, and you do want to impress people, but, like, at the same time, like, you, I don't know, you trying to be in them books, but they ain't trying to hear that, you know what I mean? Like, it's just a weird situation, and then, you know, most of the dudes that's doing bad, you know, they might be slanging a little something, so they got a little bit of money, you know what I mean? The girls go for, or I know a lot of young ladies when I was in school, they went for the college dudes, right? You know what I mean? Like, come on, man. Like, you really got to pay attention to this. Like, you know, like, why would he come to high school to mess with you when this girl's in college? Like, he's a simp. Like, he ain't got no game, so he has to, you know, go with a younger age, or
yeah,
got multiple women around. Like, you know what I mean? Like, just use common sense, but they don't. They don't.
Nah. I've been trying to put my girls on game since they were 5 and 6, man. Like, Lord Jesus.
Hey, bro. Preach. Man. Hey, man. You gotta tell them now so they know what they get, man.
Absolutely. Because they already know.
Same way.
Don't bring no nonsense to the crib. Like, it's cool. I get it. We're going to get to the point of dating. Cool. But I feel like I've already set standards with certain things. Like, I'm not going for no nonsense. You know what I mean? So we'll see. If they try me, they will know better. You know what I mean? So we'll see. We'll see.
Act them up if they don't knock on your door. Be texting,
Nick,
like,
I'm going to have that first date. Look, I already had it planned with Greg. And then Hilton lost a lot of weight, man. I was going to have Hilton at the crib before he lost his weight. And I was going to have crazy-ass Mike at the crib, chilling, and his wife beat her. So, yeah. For sure. Yeah. Already planned out, man. Let him know. We ain't.
That's funny.
But, nah, the other thing that I had was marriage. I don't know what y'all's vision of marriage was when y'all was kids. You know, like, I just thought it was going to be nothing but a lot of sex, a lot of, you know, everything that's going on. You know what I mean? Like, it was nothing but that in my head. Now, granted, 14-year-old Agby, super horny Agby, right? But marriage is hard work, dude. Like, super hard work. And it's not about just the sex. Like, granted, sex life is awesome with us. Full disclaimer, right? But in order to make it work, it takes a lot. And I'm not in everybody's house, so I could just speak of mine. And what makes us go is having that team aspect. You know, I have my role, she has a role, and we bounce off of each other, and we do it very well. When it comes to finances, teams, when it comes to the girls, teams, when it comes to everything that we're planning, it's always an open communication. But being a young dude, and granted, you know, I didn't have a great example of a marriage at the house, so I didn't really know a lot about marriage. But growing up, it's been blissful. It's been blissful. But 14-year-old Agby thought what marriage was is completely different from grown Agby.
I had to laugh, brother, because you're not the only brother that think like that. And we've had this conversation multiple times with different people over the years. You're not alone. You know, there's help, brother. You know,
I appreciate it, man. I appreciate it.
You know, we're here for you. You know what I'm saying? I'm glad you brought that up. You know what I'm saying? Because if there's help, we can talk about it. Nah, bro. But real talk, but for real, I have had that conversation a lot. Just throughout the years, and everybody's perspective on that is different, right?
Yeah.
And everybody does what works for them and theirs, which is cool. But as you have these different conversations, you understand or you learn like what everybody is doing to make their situation work for them. But the common theme, the common denominator, is exactly what you just mentioned. But
because dudes see marriage as totally different compared to what women see marriage as. Right. Like
it's the same thing with like women's thought process on the wedding. Like you said, like 14-year-old female think marriage is this grand ballroom gown party type deal. And then when they actually get married, they'll have some version of that, but it wasn't what they thought it was.
Mm-hmm. And it's hard work to get there. You know what I mean? Like it's super hard. Like money, yeah,
they leave all of that out. Yeah, all of that out until you get there. Yeah. But that's what I, you know, seeing, being in education, seeing the good dudes losing a lot, and then seeing where we were too. Just being transparent. We just celebrated our 12th year anniversary Sunday. And
congratulations.
Yeah, I appreciate that. Appreciate that. But year one and two, wow. Yeah, that was rough. I say years one through four was probably rough. But sticking in there, working on each other, working on myself, that's key too. Just learning as you grow older, knowing like, all right, can't keep on making the same mistakes, young dude. You know what I mean? Like, try to learn from it. And then working on myself, that's been super helpful to where we are now. Like, we go hours of just talking now, when at the beginning, I'm like, I'm just trying to play the game, yo. Like, what we doing right now? I don't want to talk. You know what I mean? But now is we talk all the time. We laugh all the time. So it's real blissful right now. Can't lie.
Good.
That's what's up. That happens in year 12. I'm playing.
Oh shit. No, because it was at one point I'm like, you looking over at that person like, I can't believe I did this shit. This is a life sentence, man.
I'm joking, man. Everybody experiences different, man. Oh, you got to find what works for you, which was my problem, right? So me and Lamar, I know we both said this to our fathers. Like, you just didn't set up the expectations correctly, right? You know what I mean? Like,
you taught us everything that you wanted us to learn, but didn't tell us what we should have learned.
Yeah. Like,
need to do this. Listen to me, boy. You need to do that.
I know you married. I know you've been married this whole time. But what you didn't tell me is that your marriage is not the model for all marriages. Like, this is completely different. Like, you can't just, like, I can't look at the way that you handle things and the way that you talk to your wife and think that I can talk to my wife the exact same way. Like, you know, it don't work. So, like, I was like, man, that's the one thing that out of everything he's taught me in life, I've even told him, I was like, this is where both of my parents, y'all kind of missed the ball on this one. Like, you should set up the expectations. Like, don't take what we do and think that it's going to apply to you. Like, it's going to be working. You got to kind of find that thing. So go into it trying to figure out who that person is instead of trying to mimic the relationships that you've seen You know what I'm saying? Because it's completely different.
Yeah, that's a gem right there. Somebody gonna need to rewind about 30 seconds and just keep on that on repeat. Yeah. Keep that on repeat, because that was a gem. Because that's the truth, man. That is the truth. Like, y'all know how I grew up, so ain't no sugarcoating. There wasn't a model. And You right, you mimic what you see. And like I said, those first 4 years, I'm like, it was straight replica of what I saw. And then the final straw was seeing my daughter and seeing me at the height of me being angry and the repercussions behind all of that. Like, yeah, I mean, did 12 hours in the joint and behind Chelsea. So that was for me, going to back to what I was saying, I had to work on me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I can't continue to try to control or try to mold this person if I can't even damn mold myself. You know what I mean? So that was my aha moment. Yeah, if you will, like, all right, you dumbass nigga, you about to drop and lose everything in the time you can't control your anger. You know what I mean? So that was it.
Now, I know these conversations, specifically on this particular topic, is being held like in small pockets of groups of people. And some of them, you know, have good things to say, and some of them just perpetuate the stereotype. You know,
yeah.
Because you only, you know, you're influenced by the people that you're around, but some people just only have, you know, the same core group of people around them, and they're not looking for different avenues to have this type of conversation with you to seek a different advice.
Yeah.
So I think this is a good platform to have that kind of conversation on. And I was telling Ron also that I was also thinking about starting another one. And actually, I'm actually in the process of doing this myself. And we probably need to talk, you know, offline about this, is to have those type of conversations. I know other people are doing similar type podcasts and stuff like that, but just another group of influence. And you have a different group of influence, so we can have another conversation and, you know, just grow me in talking about marriage.
Ah, absolutely, because I feel like I'm on board. Anything y'all dudes got going on, except Ron and his dope game, I don't know if I could be part of that, but I'm with it, man.
How you think we're going to bankroll all this, man? We got to funnel the money into these different projects.
Okay. I respect that. I won't ask any questions then. What you doing with that dope? No, I'm not asking any questions. But no, real talk, anything y'all dudes got going, man, I'm with it. You know, we got this relationship that's been going for a long time. And I agree. The more avenues and the more pockets that we have, I just feel like society, right, will be at a better place, because you now have somebody that, damn, we kind of the same, even though he's saying don't do it his way. I like his way because I can relate to what he has going on or what she has going on. So I'm with it. Just figure out a schedule and I'll jump on it for sure.
Yeah.
I mean, I think with our generation as a whole, just kind of wrap this up a little bit on this topic. I think our generation need to do better than what generations before us did, because everything was in-house. You know what I mean? Yeah. Which I ain't saying tell all your business. That's not what I'm saying. But like, they put on these fronts like everything's okay. You know what I mean?
White,
like,
picket fence, man.
Right, man. Like, yeah, it's not, white picket fence. It's okay, because what you're going through, I'm going through, and he going through. But like, if we all keep it to ourselves, nobody know that we going through this, and then we just isolate, and then next you know, the divorce rate goes up or whatever.
Yeah.
When all you had to do was really just talk about it. Yeah. Or depression, health, you know what I mean? Like, you saw your health start declining because you stressed out every day. You sitting in front of your house like, man, I don't even want to go in this mug.
You saw me? Nah, really, it was bad. It was bad, but
you gotta, we gotta talk, man, because like, we can't repeat, man. And social media is a Like this platform is can be good, but it can be bad at the same time, right? But yeah, we just got to use it correctly and use it for stuff like this to actually impact people's lives instead of just, you know, doing some other stuff on it.
No, I agree all the way. But the thing too, people don't want to be transparent, you know, nah. Like, and with certain people, I get it, but in order to actually go through and be successful, you got to look in the mirror and you got to take ownership of whatever it is. I don't know. I mean, in a relationship, it takes two. So obviously you got some ish going on with yourself too. And that's where I was. I just had to figure that out. Like, okay, what is my ish? Mm-hmm. And really focus in and home in on it, you mm-hmm. know, and do better. So, yeah. But that was me. You know, some people do other things. Their outlets is other things. I wasn't trying to. I was really trying to work on what I had to go to do what I said I did at the altar, right? Yeah. You know, so.
Well, here you are, 12 years, brother, on the other side, looking towards, you know what I'm saying, the future. Great stuff, good stuff.
Two good daughters,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It could, like you said, it could have turned out differently, but you here, brother.
Right. You know, after they leave, I might divorce her, you know? Nah, I'm joking. Nah. She's dope. She makes me happy. She's cool. She's real cool. I ain't gonna stunt.
Good. Well, you got anything else,
Brian? I think we covered a nice little gambit of things.
That was my favorite X-Men. Sorry.
Gambit Cole.
Oh, that was my guy. Cool.
He better come in the future.
Yeah, like the fact that he's not even here right now, like that was my favorite X-Men.
Gambit's cold.
Off top, my favorite dude, man. Yeah, he was so slick with the words and his style.
He was way better than Wolverine to me.
Yeah. His style was cold, man.
Yeah, I agree. I don't know if he's my favorite over Wolverine, but I say the cartoon version of Wolverine. But Wolverine was kind of, I mean, he was after old boy girl, man. Like he was
he was trying,
Scott boy. he should lit him up, man. Like,
and he was like that old uncle trying you too. Man. Like I'll whoop your ass and take your girl, but it's all good.
Nah, just because you can live forever don't mean nothing, man. Like,
but Gambit would talk that. What was it? That New Orleans?
That
Creole. I don't want to offend nobody. I don't want to say Creole.
But that's what it was, though. That was that French.
Yeah, like smooth. Hit you with some cards and with the damn metal pipe. So,
But nah, I ain't got nothing, Lamar.
Quick little tangent.
Yeah.
About you, brother Kevin.
That's it, man. I had my phone, but baby girl got my phone. I just remember those two things. I did text.
I looked it up. That's what you had
said
earlier.
Okay, cool. But no, that's pretty much it.
And you?
I didn't have anything else. No, I'm good. I think it was good, like you said. I'm glad that we ended them on the way that we ended it. On the marriage and stuff like that, I like that.
Yeah. Next time I need Kevin to get through 4 hours of Justice League, Zack Snyder's Justice League, so we can do a deep dive. You know.
Oh, so I'm back on this junk.
Maybe not. I don't know. You're right.
Come on, man. Can't take the vibe, man. Nah, I could do this. Yeah, I could do this. I'll check it out. Trying to think. Yeah, I'll probably check it out this weekend. I don't have gymnastics or nothing going on this weekend, so we'll check it out.
Yeah. And I'll be I got this, like I said, I just shot this weekend, so I'm going to be editing that. So that'll come out pretty soon. It's a short called Foster Kid by my homeboy, Robert Vickers. So I'm looking forward to putting it together because, like, the set was cool. Everybody was cool. All the actors did a great job, you know. So hopefully everything just turned out well when we finalize this mug in the editing process.
That's cool. Yeah, whenever you shoot your next one, man, I want to be a. I
gotta do my own project at some point.
Yeah.
No one in a while. Like I think the Michael Myers jump was the last one I did, so I got to kick something out eventually.
I'm with that.
I mean, if you want to make it, I mean, but if you cool where you are, I mean, you ain't gotta make nothing.
I'm working. Don't do me. It ain't like I'm just stagnant now. Like I'm working. Hey, these streets starting to know my name now.
I see they are.
They see the work ethic. All right, so you know when I'm on set, that's a big thing. Is everybody be like, man, you're doing a good job. You got a good eye. You know, just nonstop. Yeah, I am nonstop on set. You know what I mean?
So. Say I went to school for this shit.
Man. I got a master's. I'm not playing.
This ain't for kicks, my guy. This is real life. But yeah, always a pleasure. You know, I'm ready to star in a movie. So let me know. No, I'm not ready to star. I'm ready to be in one, though, because I'll forget lines. You'll be mad at me. You'll be like, God, get the stunt double, because this dude.
At that point, I'd just be like, just ad lib. Like, we'll figure something out. I'll dub over your voice. I've done that.
And be salty in every scene. Nah, I'm with it though. But yeah, holler at me, man. Y'all be easy. It's always good rapping with y'all. All
right.
Yeah, season 3, episode 1.
All right. Good like, episode. Subscribe. Tell your friends, your neighbors.
Comment. Let us know what you want us to talk about.
Shout out to my one dude in Ireland that's been listening to us. I don't know who you are.
That's dope.
Yeah.
That's cool. Yeah.
Hey, bro. That's real cool. Let us know what you want to talk about.
Yeah. Especially in Ireland. What's out there?
Nah, that's crazy.
Only thing I know about Ireland is they're tough, they drink a lot, and they talk ish. Every red dude. Don't want to stereotype. Don't want to be
true. It's too late. You already did.
Yeah. But I'm putting that disclaimer out, though. The guys that I've met that have been true Irish folks, not saying I was born here, my people are from there. Like, true Irish folk are super aggressive. They drank a lot, and they, you know, got down.
Hence that movie, the TV show, the Bruce Lee was called.
Oh, Warriors?
Warrior. Yeah, that's all they did. Irishmen dudes, and all they want to do is bare knuckle box.
Yeah, like they super, he was super aggressive. I was like, all right, you cool, but nah, I ain't chilling with you.
Yeah.
All right, y'all.
All right.
Y'all be easy, man.